The Roosters will give Sonny Bill Williams until kick-off to prove his fitness for tonight's grudge match against the Bulldogs. If SBW's glute is good to go, he'll line up at 5'8" against his old club. Meanwhile, the man he'll replace, James Maloney, is telling his New South Wales teammates to embrace the hate at Suncorp Stadium for State of Origin 2. Liam Cox reports.
Queensland's calling on their fans to go feral.
Yeah, bloody hope they do. I hope all the Maroons supporters come out and, you know, really let the Blues know that they're in Queensland now.
James Maloney isn't intimidated.
I think it's something you can thrive on if you use it the right way and, you know, I suppose just embrace the hate and for what it is and, you know, really enjoy it.
Nothing phases Maloney. It's a character trait halves partner Mitchell Pearce is adapting.
It's pretty special to have that sort of ability to be able to just play your role no matter what's going on. And I think he's a perfect fit for going up there to Queensland and is a big reason why we did well in game one.
Pearce has only one gripe with his roommate.
He snores a bit, which pisses me off. Yeah.
Greg Inglis was unusually quiet in game one. His opposite, Josh Morris, is wary of waking the sleeping giant.
He was pretty quiet, but knowing GI and the player that he is, he's going to want to have a big game up there.
Paul Gallen and Anthony Watmo failed to finish training today. Watmo's corked thigh is concerning.
No, I don't think it's going to stop Chocky. He'd have to cut his leg off before it'd stop him.
The Blues now break camp before flying into enemy territory on Sunday night. Liam Cox, 10 News.